Helen might only be a scribe, but she can kick some serious ass. I wouldn't mess with her if I were you.
Paladin Dance.
You ready to move out?
Why establish an outpost at the police station?
Given the nature of the facility, we felt it would be tactically advantageous to search it for weapons and ammunition. The radio tower on the roof was an unexpected boon, but it obviously has its shortcomings that need to be rectified. It might not be as imposing as the Citadel back in the capital wasteland, but it suits our purposes. That's all I'm willing to divulge at this point. Are you ready to proceed with the mission?
I think so. I'm not sure.
I need you to do whatever it takes to be combat ready. Gather anything you need from the police station so we can be on our way.
Hey. Dance.
You ready to move out?
Not yet.
Get yourself together. We've got a job to do. You ready to move out?
Ready.
Outstanding. Follow me, and try not to lag behind.
Short hike to the west. If we take this road, we should be able to avoid the larger packs of ferals infesting Cambridge. Traveling this far from the police station is a risk, but getting that transmitter up and running needs to be our top priority. If it was up to me, I'd relocate my team. But Scribe Halen detected some disturbing energy readings in the area that need to be investigated. We don't know much about them, except that they're short-lived and broadcast on a frequency only attainable with a high level of technology. We're concerned that whoever or whatever is creating those energy readings might be a potential threat. So it's our job to investigate.
Worry, 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 love is passing me by. Worry, 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 I'm so painfully shy.
When it comes to getting funny,
I'm a little quiet, dummy.
It might surprise you to learn that my recon team hit the first missile in the comic book. Over the last 7 years, two other teams have been sent here by the Brotherhood to gather technology. The first team was a huge success. They came back with crates full of pre-war artifacts and historical documents. The second wasn't so fortunate. Shortly after they arrived, we lost contact with them. They haven't been heard from since. As far as my team goes, we've lost four good men in this godforsaken wasteland. We've been a target from the moment we arrived. But despite our setbacks, I don't intend to give up and head home, or end up missing.
To blow in my top.
A man, if it walks, if it talks, if its habits are a little bit peculiar, if it brags and tries to make you think it's wonderful, be
listen
on
up.
The lookout.
We do this clean and quiet. No heroics and by the book. Understood?
On one knee, saying,
why are we at ArcJet again?
We're here to retrieve a device that will boost the signal from the radio tower at the Cambridge police station. Without it, we can't make contact with our superiors. Remember, our primary target is the deep range transmitter. Stay focused and check your fire. I don't want to be hit by stray bullets.
Excuse me, Paladin Dance.
Keep the noise
gotta
down.
Love Betty
this
Hutton,
place is
right?
Crawling with hostiles.
Right.
No time for questions right. Now. We have to keep moving.
So, this radio station, here, we don't really make any caps.
It was corporations like this that put the last nail in the coffin for mankind. They exploited technology for their own gains, pocketing the cash and ignoring the damage they'd done. It appears as though the facility's automated security's already been dealt with.
Is this the Brotherhood of Steel's handiwork?
Unfortunately, no. Look at the evidence. There isn't a single spent ammunition casing or drop of blood in sight. These robots were assaulted by Institute synths.
Synth. Isn't that the same as robot?
They're an abuse of technology created by the Institute. Abominations meant to improve upon humanity. It's unacceptable. They simply can't be allowed to exist.
What's the Institute?
They're a group of scientists who went underground when the Great War started. Spent the last few decades littering the Commonwealth with their technological nightmares.
Sounds like you're scared of synths.
There's a measurable difference between being frightened and being prepared. Now, let's move out. This place is a mess, but I still see a few pieces of salvage that the Brotherhood might be interested in. After we're done here, we'll have to mark this place for sweep and retrieve. Looks like a dead end. See if you can find a way to get that door open. I'm gonna reconnoiter the area.
Thank you. must be terminated.
Got it.
Damn synths have compromised most of the facility.
Thank you. Bingo.
This is the part of the job that I love.
Nice.
Thank you.
final stop.
Hey. Bingo.
Graduated all right from high school. It's fine. I'm sure he took shop class. Oh, look, he's reading the science mags. How cute.
Har, har, har. Shop class. Let's see them make this in shop class. My marvel of engineering. The finest in weaponized refuse acceleration. My beauty. My junk jet. They'll see. The engineers with their suits and fancy. Monday morning, they'll all see.
Warning. Power loss detected. Engine core is offline.
Yes.
engine core power restored.
By order of the Institute,
thermal engine fueled, primed, and standing by for your command.
Excuse me, Paladin Dance.
Enough chatter. We've got a job to do.
Going down.
Service elevator to the surface.
Over here. Grab that.
Well, that could have gone smoother, but mission accomplished.
Smoother? I thought we did fine.
That sweep was sloppy. We were caught unprepared more than once, which is unacceptable. However, your extra gun gave us the edge we needed. I'm not certain I could have accomplished the mission alone.
I thought we worked well as a team.
Agreed. It's a refreshing change to work with a civilian who can follow orders properly. That being said, I believe we have two important matters to discuss. First and foremost, if you'll hand me the deep range transmitter, I'd like to compensate you for your assistance during this operation. I think you'll find this weapon useful. It's my own personal modification of the standard Brotherhood laser rifle. May it serve you well in battle.
Don't you need to keep it?
This isn't the only weapon at my disposal. Brotherhood soldiers always carry a backup. Now, as far as the second matter goes, I wanted to make you a proposal. We had a lot thrown at us back there. Our op could have ended in disaster, but you kept your cool and handled it like a soldier. There's no doubt in my mind that you've got what it takes. The way I see it, you've got a choice. You could spend the rest of your life wandering from place to place, trading an extra hand for a meager reward. Or, you could join the Brotherhood of Steel and make your mark on the world. So, what do you say?
So, what would be expected of me if I joined?
You'd be under my command, and I'd expect you to follow orders. No more mercenary work. This is the real thing. You'd have access to advanced military weapons, as well as your own personal suit of power armor. Most importantly, you'd have the Brotherhood at your back, ready to spill its own blood to keep you alive. Offer still stands. Can we count on you?
I'd be honored to join.
That's what I wanted to hear. Meet me back at the police station, and we'll discuss the details.
Hey there, sister. You looking for chems?
You sell chems?
Yeah, that's right. Whatever you need, I can hook you up. I mean, my selection's a bit limited, but what's mine is yours. Know what I mean?
Let's see what you have.
All right. Check it out.
You just heard Billie Holiday. Lucky you.
Useless. Won't be able to pick this.
song by the song. I'm gonna play it.
Worry, love is passing me by. So painfully shy. Love the guys get all the kisses.
Why am I the one who misses?
Worry, 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 woe is me.
Worry, worry.
Baby, 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 I'm a fool about love.
Locke's really strong.
Maybe, maybe I should go to school about love. When it comes to getting chummy,
I'll admit I'm quite a dummy.
Worry, 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 woe is me. I found out that I'm the worrying kind. I go worrying right. Life is fine, but with the worry in mind.
So many things can go wrong.
Worry, 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 should I hold her so tight? Worry, 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 am I kissing her right? She said,
Joe, it's you I'll marry.
I'm not Joe. Worry, 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 am I kissing her right? She said,
Joe, it's you I'll marry.
I'm not Joe, my name is Harry. Worry, 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 woe is me.
Nothing there now. What do you think?
I don't know. Jump in a shadow.
Yeah, yeah. Oh, fight!
There's no ways. There's no ways.
First you say you do, and then you don't. And then you say you will, and then you won't. You're undecided now, so what are you gonna do? Now you wanna play, and then it's no. And when you say you stay, that's when you go. You're undecided now, so what are you gonna do? I've been sitting on the fence, and it doesn't make much sense, 'cause you keep me in suspense, and you know it. Then you promise to return. When you don't, I really burn. Well, I guess I'll never learn, and I show it. If you've got a heart, and if you're kind, then don't keep us apart. Make up your mind. You're undecided now, so what are you gonna do?
Thank you.
Cause you keep me in suspense and you know it. Then you promise to return. When you don't, I really burn. Well, I guess I'll never learn. And I show it. If you got a heart and if you're kind, and don't keep us apart, make up your mind. You're undecided now, so what are you gonna do? Now if you don't love me, I wish you'd say so. I love you so much, honey, I just got to know. I'm just a fool for you. What are you gonna do?
Fucking hide from me?
You're dead!
When Madam Pompous door was on a ballroom floor, said all the gentlemen obviously, the madam has the cutest personality. And think of all the books about DuBarry's looks. What was it made of? The toast of Paris. She had a well-developed personality.
What did Romeo see in Juliet? Or Pierrot in Pierrette? Or Jupiter in Juno?
You know. And when Salome danced and had the boys in trance, no doubt it must have been easy.
Or even just a bit bored at the knees. If she could show a faultless personality.
Why are certain girls offered certain things, like sable coats and wedding rings, by men who wear their spats right?
That's right! So don't you say I'm smart and have the kindest heart. Oh, what a wonderful sister I'd be.
Just tell me how you like my
personality.
Baby, you've got the cutest
personality.
That was Personality.
That's it.
By Johnny Mercer. And now, a word, or several, from our sponsors. Fallon's Basement, providing top-of-the-line fashion to Diamond City for over 10 generations. Here's Dear Hearts and Gentle People, which I kind of think maybe Bob Crosby was, well, exaggerating. At least, I mean, I'm not accusing him of anything, though. I'm just saying I've never met either of those category of person. Take it away, Bob.
I love those dear hearts
and gentle people
who live in my hometown.
Because those dear hearts and gentle people will never ever let you down. They read the good book from Friday till Monday. That's how the weekend goes.
How it goes.
I've got a dream house I'll build there one day, with picket fence and rambling rows. I feel so welcome. Time that I
nice.
And my happy heart keeps laughing like a clown. I love those dear hearts
and gentle people who live and love
in my hometown. They read the good book from Friday till Monday. That's how the weekend goes. I've got a dream house I'll build there
feel so welcome each time that I return. That my happy heart keeps laughing like a clown.
Like a clown,
I love those dear hearts
and gentle people
who live and love in my hometown.
In my hometown, those dear hearts and gentle people.
Drums on a whole bass horn. Somebody beating on a ding dong. Come on over, baby. Whole lot of shaking going on. Come on over, baby. Baby, you can't go wrong. Ain't nobody faking. Whole lot of shaking going on. We found out.
a soul. We found out. Now we know that Grandma plays the numbers. We found out. Yes, oh yes.
Yeah.
We found out. We found out. We found out. Now we know that Grandma plays the numbers. She's at the fruit stand every day. Buys bananas by the bunch. She looks at all the price tags. That's why she gets her hunch. We found out. Yes, we know. We found out.
Bless her soul.
We found out. Now we know that Grandma plays the numbers.
Hey, Grandma, did you get your numbers in yet?
Well, I'm happy to hear, son.
Well, what did you play?
3, 6, 9.
Well, what do you know?
Winoni Harris.
Got it.
Here's a thing. A sort of a note, I guess, from a sponsor here in Diamond City. And I'll just read it. Commonwealth Weaponry. It's a dangerous world out there. Protect yourself. Protect your family. Here's Ray Smith with Right Behind You, Baby. A song that really sounds nice when you hear it at 2 in the morning. Whispered really close in your ear. You know?
You can run like a rabbit, fly like a bee. No matter what you do, you'll never get away from me. Because I'm right behind you, baby.
Don't
don't think I can pick this.
The world on fire. I just want to start a flame in your heart. In my heart, I have but one desire. And that one is you. No other will do. I've lost all ambition for worldly acclaim. I just want to be the one you love. And with your admission that you feel the same, I'll have reached the goal I'm dreaming of. Believe me, I don't want to set the world on fire. I just want to start a flame in your heart.
I don't want to set the world on fire, honey. I love you too much. I just want to start a great big flame down in your heart. You see, way down inside of me, darling, I have only one desire. And that one desire is you. And I know nobody else ain't gonna do.
I've lost all ambition for worldly acclaim. I just wanna be the one you love. And with your admission that you feel the same, I'll have reached the goal I'm dreaming of. Believe me, I don't want to set the world.
I'll wear your guts around my neck!
I just want to start a flame in your heart.
The ink spots. That was them. I mean, there they are. Singing, I don't want to set the world on fire. Irony. This is Diamond City Radio, and I'm, you know, it's me, Travis. Anyway, here's Sheldon Allman with Crawl Out Through the Fallout. Probably some bad advice overall, but, you know, it rhymes.
Crawl out through the fallout, baby, when they drop that bomb. Crawl out through the fallout with the greatest of aplomb. When your white count's getting higher, hurry, don't delay. I'll hold you close and kiss those radiation burns away. Crawl out through the fallout, baby, to my loving arms.
What's that?
Said this bomb was clean. If you cannot find the way, just listen for my song. I'll love you all your life, although that may not be too long. Crawl out through the fallout, baby, to my loving arms. I see the
Just flew into this town and he's chopping up all the women's meat.
He's acting in white.
crutches, 'cause I'm a wanderer. Yeah, a wanderer. I roam around, 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 around. Oh, well, I roam from town to town. I go through life without a care. And I'm as happy as a clown. I with my two fists of iron, but I'm going nowhere. Oh, yeah, I'm the type of guy that likes to roam around. I'm never in one place. I roam from town to town. And when I find myself, I'm falling for some girl. Yeah, I hop right into that car of mine. I drive around the world. Yeah, I'm a wanderer.
Sky by Nat King Cole. You love this one, right? It's a real classic. Sure.
Wait there. Come on.
heading down the road and I ain't coming back. Ain't no red light gonna make me stop. When I find that big, heading down the road and I ain't coming back. Ain't no red light gonna make me stop.
Disappearing, Anka!
Undecided by Ella Fitzgerald. I know the feeling, Ella. I know the feeling.
This is bullshit.
And now, a word, or several, from our sponsors. Commonwealth Weaponry. It's a dangerous world out there. Protect yourself. Protect your family. Would you like some Danny Kay? I sure thought so.
This is bullshit! Come out and fight!
So dead! Not that good!
Each morning, a missionary of the gods be on sign. He tells the native population that civilization is dying.
Come on out.
Savages, holler for bamboo tree.
Trust me.
Bango bango, being I refuse to go. Don't want no bright lights, false teeth, doorbells, landlords, I make it clear.
That no matter how they coax him,
I'll stay right here. I look through a magazine the missionary's wife conceals.
Magazine, what happens?
I see how people who are civilized bung you with automobiles.
You know you can get hurt that way, Daniel?
At the movies they have got to pay many coconuts to see.
What do they see, Donnie?
Uncivilized pictures that the movie takes of me.
So, bongo, 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 he don't wanna leave the Congo. No, 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 no. Bingo, bango, bongo, he's so happy in the jungle he refused to go.
Don't want no penthouse, bathtub, streetcars, taxis, noise in my ear.
So no matter how they coax him,
I'll stay right here.
They hurry like savages to get aboard an iron train.
The Tringalimbahula Humble Express.
And though it's smoking and it's crowded, they're too civilized to complain.
When they've got 2 weeks vacation, they hurry to vacation ground.
What do they do, Donnie?
They swim and they fish, but that's what I do all year round.
So, bongo, 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 I don't wanna leave the Congo. No, 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 no. Bingo, bango, bongo, I'm so happy in the jungle, I refuse to go.
Don't want no jailhouse,
shotgun,
fish hooks,
golf clubs,
I got my spears.
So no matter how they coax him,
I'll stay right here.
They have things like the autumn bomb,
so I think I'll stay where I am.
Civilization, I'll stay right here.
Shake.
smokes a great big cigar, and it hangs around at a bar. If it tells the biggest lies, wears the loudest ties, it's a male. If it acts just like a cross patch, has a face with whiskers that scratch, if it's stubborn as can be, mean and ornery, it's a man. If it walks, if it talks, if its habits are a little bit peculiar, if it brags and tries to make you think it's wonderful, be on the lookout, don't let it fool ya. But if it makes the moon up on high more than just a light in the sky, if it kisses you and you find you like it too, grab it, it's a man. Each time you pass, owns a car that runs out of gas, then it's time that you get a better watch your step. It's a man. Hold it. Hang on to it. For it's a man.
Gotta love Betty Hutton, right? Some people help me stay in the air. People like this. Why drink dirty radioactive water when you could have it pure and bottled? Chen Kowalski's Clean Water Market, straight from the filter. Keep a Knockin' by Louis Jordan is next. I like this one. It's short and it's about telling people to go away. Oh, Louis.
Silver Shroud fans, I got an urgent mission. If you're a true fan, stop by the Memory Den and to talk to Kent Conley. The Silver Shroud needs you.
Who's there?
Galaxy News Radio.
When evil walks the streets of Boston, one man lurks in the shadows, shielding the innocent, judging the guilty. That guardian is the Silver Shroud. Today's episode, a slaying in Scully Square.
Just down this alley.
Well, well, well. Looks like someone got lost on the wrong side of the track.
I'm just meeting a friend. No business of yours. Perhaps I'll just call him. Now, if you'll excuse me.
Not so fast, fancy pants. Your wallet and that snazzy briefcase you're carrying. Hand them over, now.
I most certainly will not. Do you have any idea who...
Oh, jeez, Louise. Why'd you go and do that?
Because he could have made us, that's why. You want to spend another stretch in the pokey? Let's see what's in this fancy case. Nothing! Papers, no cash, it's worthless! Get his wallet. A suit like this has got to have something.
All right, let's see. $20, a driver's license. Oh, man. We've done it this time. You know who this is? We just wasted Mayor Murphy!
What? The Mayor Murphy? What in the blazes was he doing up here? Up in Scully Square?
A mystery, to be sure.
Who said that? Show yourself!
You have murdered a man in cold blood. Justice must be served. It's the Silver Shroud! Let's get out of here!
I ain't afraid of the Silver Shroud. You hear me? Come out and I'll do you like I did the mayor.
Death has come for you, evildoer, and I am its shroud! My work here is done. Or is it? What brought you to Scully Square, Mayor Murphy? A journey that left you dead and Boston leaderless. Why venture? Emerge from the shadows, villain, or face the justice of the Silver Shroud!
What will become of our stalwart hero? Find out what happens next week. On another exciting episode of The Silver Shroud.
You've been listening to Galaxy News Radio, a wholly owned subsidiary of Galaxy News Network.
Galaxy News Radio.
When evil walks the streets of Boston, one man lurks in the shadows, shielding the innocent, judging the guilty. That guardian is the Silver Shroud. Today's episode, The Mystery of Mayor Murphy.
Slowly now, reveal yourself.
Silver Shroud. Fret not, old friend. It's only me.
Mistress of mystery, what brings you to Scully Square on such a foul night?
Tracking our dear Mayor Murphy, who is up to some mischief.
The mayor? So he wasn't here in some kind of official capacity?
Hardly. Here, let me show you. The contents of the late mayor's case.
But these are real estate papers. Leases and deeds for most of the businesses in Scully Square.
Indeed they are, my intrepid investigator. It would seem our Mayor Murphy was involved in a rather crooked caper. He was here to meet with some other mysterious malefactor.
So, Mr. Mayor, I hope you found the place all... What the? Silver Shroud? And Mistress of Mystery?
The infamous Mampos. So, you were meeting with Mayor Murphy. But why? Tell me, and you may yet live.
Best listen to my friend, Fahey.
I'll never talk. And you two are in over your heads.
So be it. Death has come for you, evildoer, and I am its...
Shroud? Shroud this, crime fighter? Later, suckers!
Silver Shroud! You're shot!
Just a graze. You must go after him.
No, we'll let our quarry flee for now. That bullet must be removed. And you're bleeding. Bad.
Must get back to my...
Hush now, Stoic Shroud. I'll take you to my parlor. It is closed, and that wound is worrisome.
It's been so long.
Indeed it has, old friend. Old love. Indeed it has. And now, we must away!
What will become of our stalwart hero? Find out what happens next week
on another exciting episode of The Silver Shroud. You've been listening to Galaxy News Radio, a wholly owned subsidiary of Galaxy News Network.
Galaxy News Radio.
When evil walks the streets of Boston, one man lurks in the shadows, shielding the innocent, judging the guilty. That guardian is the Silver Shroud. Today's episode in the Parlor of Mysteries.
Jasmine, chamomile, pain, ecstasy. This can only be the den of mysteries.
Be still, sweet shroud. I removed that scumbag slug, but you're sick with fever and still suffering.
Mistress of Mysteries, no. I'm all right. But the mayor, Fat Fady, we stumbled upon a most sinister plot, old friend.
Ha! No, dear heart. The shroud stumbled. The mistress maneuvered. I knew of the mayor's misdeeds for many days. I followed him to that fateful meeting with Fat Fahey. I was about to...
Attention! Silver Shroud and Mistress of Mystery! This is Chief Corcoran of the Boston Police Department. We know you're in there. You are both wanted in connection with the murder of Mayor Murphy. Come out with your hands up!
It would seem that our leaving the scene of the Scale slaughter was terribly timed. Incurring the wrath of Boston's finest is an unfortunate and unexpected annoyance.
Unexpected by us, maybe. But perhaps not by Fat Faye. I'm starting to see into his twisted plan. Damn this gunshot wound.
Look, heroes! We can clear this up. Come out now, unarmed. I'll see that you two get the best lawyers in the city.
Excuse my assumption that even the most astute attorney couldn't help us now.
All right, mistress. We must away from your den and evade the police. Clear our names and take Fahey down.
That's it. We're coming in.
Silver Shroud, Mistress of Mystery, hands up per order of the Boston Police.
Chief Corcoran, I am Death's Shroud, but you are undeserved of my terrible justice. Think on my mercy.
Stop or we'll shoot. Men, open fire. Damn it, where did this mist come from?
Clearing. Chief, they ain't here. They're gone.
I was hoping you'd say that, Officer Leibowitz. I was hoping you'd say that.
What will become of our stalwart hero? Find out what happens next week on another exciting episode of The Silver Shroud.
You've been listening to Galaxy News Radio, a wholly owned subsidiary of Galaxy News Network.
Galaxy News Radio.
When evil walks the streets of Boston, one man lurks in the shadows, shielding the innocent, judging the guilty. That guardian is the Silver Shroud. Today's episode, Fat Fahey's Folly.
Come on, Dollface. It's right through here.
Aw, gee, Polly. I ain't never been in a secret gangster hideout before.
What the? Polly, you dumb jamoke. What's the big idea? Bringing a dame into our hideout. Into my hideout.
Nah, relax, boss. She's all right. Ain't you all right, Wendy? Cindy? yeah?
It's candy. And yeah, of course I'm all right. I'm just a young, dumb girl in love with a handsome, dangerous man.
Ah, brother. All right, the skirt can stay, but close that door. Last thing we need is...
The Silver Shroud, infiltrating your nefarious lair.
Holy cannoli! It's the Nightmare of Night, the Deceptive Detective, the Dark Dick! Polly, you idiot! You were duped! That's no normal dame!
Quite right, you custodian of criminality, for I am not Candy's captivating companion. It is I, the Mistress of Mystery. I have clouded Polly's paltry perceptions to gain access to your den of depravity.
Sorry, boss! I had no idea!
Your mistake is our gain, Polly, is it? Death has come for you, evildoer, and I am its shroud!
Polly, no! Okay, listen. Whatever you want, Silver Shroud. I'll do it. Just don't kill me, too.
Pathetic and predictable when faced with fear. The cocksure culprit.
Oh, you too. Crime fighters? What a laugh. And you call me predictable. You don't got any idea, do you?
Why, the joviality, Fahey. I, the Silver Shroud, have got you dead to rights. Yet you persist in this mindless guffawing. Not the behavior I'd expect of a criminal mastermind.
And you're right. Criminal mastermind? Me? Bub, you're as dumb as that getup. I'm just a pawn in this game, pal. You see, my master, the real master, he's been pulling all the strings.
You mean?
That's right, mistress. This was all just a big distraction. While we were here having our little jaw session, my boss has been at your parlor, stealing back those deeds you took from Mayor Murphy's briefcase.
Treacherous toad. You defiled my sacred sanctum. Oh, for that, you will feel my fury. Behold the blade of Bastet!
Mistress, no! We needed him alive.
Ha! That was never going to happen. I have never been... alive, you see.
By the shadows, Fat Fahey is... he is a robot.
Wow. Ain't you quite the detective? Too bad your career as a crime fighter is over. Lockbots, attack!
Monster robots, assaulting from all angles. Not even the Silver Shroud can kill what isn't alive!
Watch me, mistress! Watch me!
What will become of our stalwart hero? Find out what happens next week on another exciting episode of... The Silver Shroud!
You've been listening to Galaxy News Radio, a wholly owned subsidiary of Galaxy News Network.
Galaxy News Radio.
When evil walks the streets of Boston, one man lurks in the shadows, shielding the innocent, judging the guilty. That guardian is the Silver Shroud. Today's episode, Into the Robot's Den.
That's all of them. Fat Fahey's mob bots have been sent back to the mechanical hell that spawned them.
Yes, my choleric companion.
Won't be able
and
to
no,
pick this.
Robotic hellspawn they were. But not Fat Fahey's. For he himself presented the facts.
of Southie. One of the mob bot heads is still talking.
You darn right I am. I can't feel my legs, cause you shot me up good, Shroud. But I still got my kiss to see, and I'm gonna use it to tell you where the big boss man is, see?
And your one condition?
You take my head with you, so I can see you take that creep down. Yeah, what did he ever do for me, huh? Okay, so he created me. Whoop-dee-doo. Who needs a father who sends his kids out to die?
Silver Shroud, I sense truth in this clockwork crook. Shall I?
Use your blade of bastard to free the Mabot's head from its now destroyed body. Do it.
Ha! Sweet freedom! Thanks, Dollface!
Now tell us, who is your creator? The robotic puppet master pulling your twisted wires? Speak, you decapitated electronic evildoer!
That will spoil all the fun. You gotta see for yourself. Come on, let's beat feet to the big warehouse down at Pier 12.
Fine, you amoral automaton. We're away.
A moonless night and an unguarded skylight. Just what we needed to stealthily infiltrate this warehouse.
Yes, and our view from above is advantageous, for the gathering below is unlike any soiree I've ever seen.
Robots. Dozens of them. All shapes and sizes. And on the stage, their leader. Another robot. No, not a robot. A man in a robot costume.
only future you have is a long nap in a deep hole, mechanist. To me, you're just another two-bit hustler with delusions of grandeur. And by the way, you're not fooling anyone with that cheap getup. You're as human as the rest of us.
Stalwart Shroud, glance skyward and see. Our newfound friend, the head of the bodiless butt. And it would seem he's biting through our bindings.
Hey down there, mechanist! You robot wannabe! Remember me? No? I didn't think so. That's the problem. You made me, but you didn't love me! You didn't love any of us, you selfish jabalk! Now, it's time to pay!
Gasp!
Fools, all of you! Attack my robot children! Destroy these interlopers!
The robots are advancing, and our weapons have been confiscated. So, fisticuffs it is, then.
And furiously fluid footwork. Hi-ya!
By order of our master, the mechanist, you will be destroyed. Destroy it.
Is the last of them. Now, for the mechanist. But where did that vile ruffian escape to?
Hey, Silver Do-Gooder, it's me, the head. Yeah, that's right. I'm up here in the rafters. I'm your eye in the sky. I saw where the mechanist went. He's in that office, up the stairs.
Well done. Your adjusted attitude has made allies of us all. Silver Shroud, shall we?
We shall.
Stop right there! Not a step closer! You may have defeated my robot children, but now I will turn your own weapon against you.
Silver Shroud, he's armed with your silver shooter, your most revered rifle.
So he is, Mistress. So he is. All right, Mechanist. It's your move. Shoot!
Silver Shroud!
Or in the yard, your family will love a robot from Bethesda's.
Whoops!
house or in the yard, your family will love a robot from Hester's. A robot from Hester's means quality, safety, and reliability. Hester's guarantee of safety. Hester's takes the hassle out of robot shopping.
Hey.
contact.
Hold it right there.
Engaging.